negative imagery, a lot of stereotypical things where it's usually somebody in complete black attire, something abusive, something negative, something obviously not the norm that I'm used to. Couple that with Islamophobia, and today's, it's so weird, like I'm beatboxing while I'm speaking.
I'm sorry.
Is this live?
Yeah.
Oh, great. Anyway, so with everything that's happening politically with the Muslim ban, with hate crimes on the rise and stuff, there was this real need and desire for us to change that narrative and change that negative stereotype about Muslim women. And so what we decided to do, a group of us, was really just to start connecting with one another. And the more we started making connections, the more we started to see, like, wow, there's some pretty amazing women out there. And they're doing phenomenal work, but like nobody knows about it. Usually it's because we've got that sort of imposter syndrome of like, no, I just want to be behind the scenes. Yeah. And then other times there's other people taking credit for the work that we're doing. So we thought, well, let's do a couple of things. Let's connect all these awesome women to each other. And then let's challenge this negative narrative by taking it back and telling our own stories ourselves. So we launched this storytelling project called Muslim Sheroes of Minnesota. So I'm assuming that I don't need to explain what Sheroes is. I've had to in a couple of different settings. So the storytelling project starts to highlight local Muslim women doing amazing work, right? We found 4 tennis players at a local high school who advocated to have the religious headscarf as part of their tennis outfit. We found a blind chemist whose research today on surfactants, I don't know what that is, but it would really enhance the way drugs are delivered to chronically ill patients. We found social entrepreneurs who are doing events planning, who are working on social justice activities. We even found a chaplain in Augsburg College. We found a deaf ed teacher who, because her son was born with a hearing disorder, she had to learn sign language, and her challenge was that she noticed there were no resources in her Muslim community, and she became that resource for her community. We found a street soccer coach who is working with both girls and boys in her community to make sure that they stay in the community and give back. We also found a sheikha, which is the equivalent of a scholar who can give legal edicts in Islam. And most of the time you only see men, but there are tons of women that go unnoticed. We also found a woman who, in her full niqab and burqa, which is the entire covering, started an organization called Bloom, which brings women together to do outdoorsy things. They go canoeing, they just came back from a camping trip, they go horseback riding, all things that people would think that, oh, she's all covered and in this long dress, she probably can't do it. And she's busting those myths. You guys are actually really, really lucky tonight because one of the sheroes that we featured is actually here tonight. And I see her kind of cowering back there. And I know you're going to introduce her later, but Kenya is one of the sheroes who is building economic power for black women in her community. So it'll be really exciting to hear her. Expressions, which is a blog for Muslim women to write about the work that they're doing in their own words. Because not all the time can we as writers write the experience that somebody has lived through better than the person in their own words. And then next, what we're going to do is hopefully do a podcast, which I was just telling Ivy. Where are you, Ivy? I told her I've been procrastinating on it, and she said, well, what are you doing to like stop procrastinating? I said, I bought a book. And she goes, did you read it? And I was like, no.
Of course not.
So yeah. We wanted to do a podcast because people really love reading, you know, this 800-word write-up on Ishiro. They like watching the 90-second, two-minute video, but they always want more. And so we're hoping that the podcast will give you a deeper understanding and connection to the woman that you're listening to. Now, people ask, what type of effect has this had on the community? And I'll tell you, it's been pretty interesting, pretty amazing. One is that it has a great effect on Muslim women in general, right? The question we ask, that I often ask myself, is how can I be what I cannot see? So if I can't see Muslim women in leadership positions or in positions of power, why would I ever aspire to that? And so when we put Muslim women up on the stage, we see that, oh, hey, I can do something. Right. And so we really inspire Muslim women to be able to step up and engage in their community. One of the cool things of one of our Shiro digital shorts that went out was, you know, people from all around the world get to see the video, and the Shiro that we had featured got a call to come out to South Africa to a conference and speak at. So it's really opening up some cool opportunities for us. And then the second is really around this broader community, right? Of all our Minnesotans and all these women who see, hey, there's a somewhat marginalized community with a very negative stereotype, but now I have an alternative source to be able to learn about Muslim women and the contributions that they have in their community. So we see that this has opened up a lot of different avenues for the work that we're doing. We're really excited because when we think about the whole idea around like sponsorship, I think about how our organization has kind of become this gatekeeper to Muslim women. And so we open up this pathway to access to all these great women in our network so that they are invited to events like this and are able to share their stories. So you're probably wondering, what can you do? One is go to our website, revivingsisterhood.org, watch the Shiro videos, read about these amazing women, and then share them with people in your network. You know, a simple tweet or a Facebook post about one of the Shiro that really touches your heart, post that out. You'll be amazed to see like how many people are reading and kind of those stereotypes are really kind of breaking for them. Second is nominate someone. If there's anybody in here that tells me they don't know a Muslim woman, like tonight you can be friends with me and Kenya and Iftu, and that'll be three for you guys. And then of course, lastly, we want your ideas, right? Like what's worked in your organizations? What could we do to take our project to the next level? Help us make those connections and help us understand what that next level could be. So I'm excited that I heard Women Lead MSP, which I think is a hashtag. I'm just gonna add Muslim in there and make it hashtag Muslim Women Lead MSP.